So the Z Fold 3 videos have been going down really well recently, so why not take a look at my best Android apps for the Galaxy Z Fold 3 of 2022? So I'm gonna kick the episode off with a bit of a controversial one. So there's tons of apps out there that we all know about, but tend to ignore for one of two reasons. First reason, they're just bad, or the second reason is that there's much better competitors out there. And I'm thinking Spotify, for example. Hear me out on this one, Amazon Prime Music. Now, there's one reason and one reason alone that made me think, okay, I'm gonna give this one a go, and that is because currently they have an offer on giving you 3 months of free Amazon Prime Music. So my thinking was that surely it's going to be good enough to get me through 3 months, and it's going to save me 3 months on my Spotify payments. And you know what, it's actually not half bad. So it's got a really nice, clean, simple UI. It's very easy to navigate, very easy to find your way around. Yes, there are things that I do miss about Spotify. For example, my release radar, I listen to that every single Friday. I absolutely love it, but it has actually got me through at least a month now of not really missing Spotify too much, if I'm honest. It has a really good library of different artists and genres. So for a lot of you, for the sake of saving yourself, what, 7, 14, 21, 22 pounds, it might actually be worth it. And that brings us on to our question of the day. Spotify or Amazon Prime Music, the slightly cheaper alternative. Is it actually worth it, or is it just a complete waste of time? Let me know in the comment section what you think. Now, our next app is one that will specifically benefit you if you own a Z Fold 3, and that is SwiftKey. Now, this one was brought to my attention by a couple of subscribers on my latest Galaxy Z Fold 3 review video. And what it'll do is actually make your Galaxy Z Fold 3 cover display experience a hell of a lot easier and just better all round. This keyboard, in my opinion, is a lot better than the stock Samsung keyboard, and it also comes with a bunch of cool customization features. For example, you can get this cool gray and orange theme that I'm rocking here. And to be honest, because it looks so good and feels so good, I think this is going to be my go-to keyboard for the foreseeable future now. Not only am I enjoying it on the cover display, I'm also enjoying it on the inner display. I think it's better all around, so definitely check this one out and let me know down in the comments what you think of SwiftKey. Has it made your Z Fold 3 experience better, or do you prefer the stock Android keyboard? Next up is a finance app. Now, this isn't an app specific to the Z Fold 3. It's just an essential app that I always have on all of my phones, and that is the Curve app. So what Curve is essentially a digital wallet. We've spoken about it many times on the channel before. You can store all of your debit cards, all of your loyalty cards and credit cards all on one card. You'll get sent a free physical card unless you pay for the metal version like I do. This is the Curve Red Metal card. So once you get your card, you can pick up to 6 different retailers to earn 1% cashback on. For example, I use Amazon and I even use Curve with my business card. So I get 1% cashback on all of my purchases, even the ones I make for Tech It Easy. So I actually make quite a decent amount of money back using it. And the features don't stop there. You've also got the go back in time feature, which allows you to move payments from one card to another up to 30 days after making a purchase. And then there's also the anti-embarrassment mode. So if you say have your Barclay card loaded up and you go to pay for something at the checkout, you haven't got enough money in there, it will automatically move that purchase onto a different card that you have stored on your Curve card, preventing you from getting declined at the checkout, and as the name suggests, preventing any embarrassing moments. Curve for me has been an essential tool for budgeting and just everyday use, to be honest. So there will be a link down below. I think if you sign up at the moment, you get £5 and 1% cash back. It's definitely worth trying out, in my opinion. It could save you quite a bit of money. Our next app is maybe one that is quite obvious or not. It's actually the Kindle app. So Kindle isn't just a physical tablet for reading books on, it's also an app that you can download to your Z Fold 3. And because of the book-like folding display on the Z Fold 3, it makes it an even better experience. So I'm pretty sure you all know what Kindle does now. It allows you to browse, purchase, and store books, and then you can just read them straight off your phone. And with Samsung's new extra dim feature that we covered in my One UI 4.0 video, it makes reading a lot easier on the eyes, especially at nighttime. In my opinion, this app goes really nicely with the Kindle Unlimited plan. I think if you sign up to that, you get like a month's free or something with that. So if you are into reading books, definitely check that out. Now, if you don't like reading but do like your books, you can also try out Audible. This is one that I've recently tried out and I've absolutely loved it, especially at nighttime. Me and my partner both listen to them. It's not very specific to the Z Fold 3, and I'm pretty sure you know what it does now. They're all audiobooks, and if you sign up, I think you get 1 or 2 free audiobooks to download and keep forever. So I'll put a link to that down below too. You can definitely try that one out. Very, very much worth it in my opinion. And even if you don't have a Z Fold 3, it's worth getting it anyway. Next up is an app app essential for all creators and designers. This one is called Pigments. It's a very simple app, but it does a lot of groundwork for you. This is personally how I built my whole Tech It Easy branding. Basically, what you do is input a color, so you find your starting point, and then you just tap the plus button and it'll bring up other recommendations that fit in with that initial starting palette. It's a really great app, and if you are a graphic designer, this could actually prove to be a really essential tool for your workflow. We won't spend any more time on this one because I appreciate it's for quite a niche audience, but definitely try this one out. I personally found it very useful. Moving on, we've got an app for those of you who like to change their wallpapers up. This is the 4D Parallax Wallpapers app. It does what it says on the tin, really. If you want a more dynamic, exciting wallpaper for your Z Fold 3, this is the place to go. It will use your phone's gyro to give you that sort of parallax 4D effect. And in my opinion, these sorts of wallpapers just look awesome on the Z Fold 3's inner display. If you're not keen on potentially wasting a bit of extra battery life though, you can always try this app out. This is a little bit of a bonus one for you. This is Wallwrap. The UI is super clean, really easy to navigate, and it has some really good preview features for those awesome 2D wallpapers. I get a lot of the wallpapers that you see on the channel from here. So I'll put a link to both of those apps down in the description underneath the wallpaper section. Before we move off this one though, if you have seen any wallpapers that you think you might quite fancy, you can always join the Discord server. There is a wallpapers tab there where I put a lot of the wallpapers you've seen in my video thumbnails and in the videos themselves down there for you to download. So definitely check that out. It'd be really nice to have you in the Discord server as well. So next up, we've got a couple more creative apps. The first one I want to talk about is Canva. This one is for those of you who sort of struggle with creative software. It simplifies everything and gives you a bunch of templates for making things like YouTube thumbnails, Instagram posts, and even video ads for your business. So it might be aimed at those who do struggle with Photoshop, for example. It's actually a great place to pick up some inspiration for your YouTube thumbnails. I personally have actually signed up to the premium plan for this. Although I know Photoshop like the back of my hand and even use it for my full-time job, Canva's actually been great for giving me a bit of inspiration on suggesting me new fonts and layouts for my thumbnails. And the best thing is it is free. You don't actually have to pay for the premium version to make use of it. The free version actually comes with plenty of thumbnail templates and free bits and bobs to use on your thumbnails or whatever you want to use Canva for. Again, there will be a link to this down below. Let me know what you think. Next up, we've got one perfectly suited for the Galaxy Z Fold 3's inner display. Now, since the Z Fold 3 came with S Pen support, it'd be pretty rude to ignore the opportunities for that inner display when it comes to the S Pen. So this one is Ibis Paint X. It's a free painting app that offers tons of great features, including over 7,000 GPU accelerated brushes. You've also got features like rulers, blend modes, and even a layer system, much like Photoshop. One feature that really stood out to me though was the stabilizer tool for getting those really nice smooth lines. This is an incredible app, especially considering it's free. I have to admit though, my painting days are very much behind me. Now, moving on is an app for the productivity nuts out there. This is Trello. Now, I've spoken about Trello several times on my channel before. It's an essential tool for me for keeping on top of my channel, and I even use it now at work because it's just such a good tool. So I did have this on my Note 10 Plus, but because the Z Fold 3 has such a great inner display, it gives you an almost desktop-like experience. Essentially, what you can do is create different cards, different sections, add labels, add tasks, and just keep yourself really organized. This is where I do my channel plans. For example, this is how I organize mine. I have my video ideas on the left. Once I start them, I move them along. Once they're finished, I move them to the publish section. And then I also have things like additional tax, say if I need to do a tax return or something like that, then that will go in that section. It's a really great little app and it has tons of customization options. And the best part is it is free. Next up, we've got a couple of games for the Z Fold 3. So if you want to check out some really great games to play on your new folding phone, check the link over on the right-hand side now. Also, if you want to know more about the Z Fold 3 itself, check out my latest 2022 review for the Z Fold 3. For now though, I've been Alex. This has been Tech It Easy. Thank you so much for watching, and hopefully I'll see you in the next one.